Chapter 3. We ended up getting a pony. His name was Toby. He was a woods pony. Haul the tree-length logs out of the woods and drop them at a certain point where we wanted him to drop them. And what a smart little bugger he was, I'm telling you. You didn't want to carry sugar cubes in your pocket. He'd bite you. But anyways, we had a wagon. We'd hook him up to the wagon and we could take him up and down the road. And then we ended up acquiring a goat, and she helped to get rid of some of the brush. And she also gave us milk. And then we acquired some rabbits, and we raised rabbits. And then we got a pig to raise, and we got that pig when it was just a baby. And look at the size of her now. There again, she was just like a dog too. Here you can see we are in the cellar hole, and we're mixing concrete by hand. We had to shovel and sift the sand to get the rocks out. This is the beginning of starting the walls. In this photograph here, you can see where we have quite a bit of the wall done. I didn't take pictures throughout because it was a busy job. Of course, we had to use re-rod and then fill the whole cavity with concrete to give the foundation strength. In this photograph here, you can see basically the wall is pretty much done, and we're coating it with tar to keep the water out. And in the next photograph, you can see I am backfilling the foundation with a wheelbarrow. At this point, we have our mobile home up for sale. We are going to have to purchase some plywood, put the walls up. And we had already cut the 2x4s with our sawmill. We had the lumber. We had to stick and stack all the lumber. And like I said, we had our mobile home up for sale at this point because we needed the money to continue on. And in this photograph here, you see the center beam. And the center beam actually came out of a garage that we tore down for my mother. And these beams are what's called pumpkin pine, and they come from down south. And they last forever. It was treated with creosote. And here, we just got done making some steps to go down cellar. Our trailer was sold, so we had to hurry up and get ourselves into the cellar. Next photograph here is where we have to hurry up and get the floor on. Me and the boys were doing that. So here we are, putting the plywood down. When we went to purchase all that plywood, we hauled it home on a trailer. It was about 45 minutes from home, and we ended up losing a whole pallet of plywood come off the trailer. Glenn and I got out, and we had to pick all that plywood up out of the road and stack it on side of the road. But that was quite a trip in itself. But anyways, and here we are setting up the first wall. This picture here, you can tell we don't have all the walls up, but we got a wall up so that we could build an entryway to the cellar. And there's our steps. My dog actually managed to maneuver those steps and go down cellar. It was just a rough entrance, but that's all we had at the time, and it worked. And we spent months in the cellar, dirt floor. We didn't have enough money to buy all the concrete to have the floor all done, but we did our best and we made it through. Our first winter, we did not have insulation on the walls. Here the walls are basically up, and here we are covering the walls. That's actually the front of the house. And here, now we're starting with the second floor and the roof. And I am scared to death of heights. I could manage it so long as I could stand on the upper floor, pull those 2x8s up onto the second floor. I could help my husband stand them up, but I couldn't get on the outside to do any of that. See, I'm on the inside, not on the outside. All the boards, we cut all those boards. We made them. And that's my husband's brother there. He come to help my husband put the sheets of plywood on the roof. I wasn't much help there, so his brother came up for a couple of days in a row, and they managed to get all the plywood on. And we're putting the upstairs walls up. And there we are. We got a roof over our head now.